Good morning, world. It's 4:30 a.m. and it's August 14, 2014. And I'm up pretty early this morning. I'm about to disclose to you people some things that you're not going to hear. Probably not in the religious arena or the... You're not going to even hear this in the magical arena. I used to be very upset when my son and his little friend, she was a female, they used to tear out of this book, pages out of here. It's the Bible. There are lots of pages from here. Right in there. Very thin pages. And they used to roll their little marijuana with the pages in this book. And I used to be very angry with them when they did that, because I did feel that I had to respect sacred writings. But what I'm about to show you, you see this concept here? That's 01 10. It has something to do with male and female. Goetia, seagulls, dark magic, Solomon keys, Kabbalah magic, wizards and sorcerers. Y'all are about to find out why it's never wise to put the Great Spirit to the test, or to try and work the darkest rituals and ceremonial magic upon a child. I'm going to read maybe four scriptures to you people to show you that what has taken place on this planet is horrific. What is taking place in the solar system with people using this book, because the last book in here the book of Revelations is ritual ceremonial magic dealing with keys that profane the glories, which are angels. I want you people to reason. The four winds that are to be unleashed has everything to do with the four beasts, which are angels. Raphael, Gabriel, Michael, and Uriel. Those are the four winds. Those are the four angels. And the keys of Solomon are being used in Goetia with people that practice dark ritual Kabbalistic magic. And I'm going to show you how the mark of the beast, which they say is 666, is the mark of the beast, and it's a man's number. 666 really symbolizes 9, which is an infinite number, and it's also a number considered to be judgment. All the gods in this book Everything in here is fallen. It's not of the eternal, creative, loving spirit. And I already showed you what this is. 0-1, male, female, Vicious, Pisces. See, I'll close it up. 1-9, which my birthday equals 19, and then you take the 9 and the 1, and that's 10. You can never get a 0, like they're saying, saved by 0. It's going to always equal a 1. So you're about to find out why God was a perfect man in the beginning and a disabled woman in the end. And you're about to find out why there should be much respect for the woman of wisdom. Now I'm going to read some scriptures to you so you can understand something, people. Let me go to Isaiah chapter 52, verse 14. Well, I'm going to go to 15. So shall he sprinkle many nations. Kings shall shut their mouths at him for what had not been told to them. They shall see, and what they had not heard, they shall consider. You're going to give some consideration here. I've been brought back to 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 again to put more, to explain more of what this man of lawlessness is and what it's doing. And we're going to go back to that. So just follow along. But I'm going to go to Matthew chapter 24. And this is about the abomination that causes desolation spoken of in Daniel. And that's at 24:15. Okay, in 21. And then we have where it states at 31. And he will send forth his angels with a great trumpet sound, and they will gather his chosen ones together from the four winds, from one extremity of the heavens to the other extremity. These four winds are considered evil. Let me see here. Powers of evil. That's what the four winds are considered. Let's go to Revelations again. I'm going to read it at 17. Revelation 17. Nine. Here's where the intelligence that has the wisdom comes in. Remember I told you the seven heads mean mountains where the woman sits on top, and there are seven kings, five have fallen, one is, the other has not yet arrived, but when he does arrive, he must remain a short while. And the wild beast that was but is not, it's also itself is an eighth king, but springs from the seventh, and it goes off into destruction. All of these kings that are mentioned here are considered fallen angels. The ones in Daniel chapter 11 are considered fallen angels. I told y'all this was a grimoire of a Goetia. And they're using seals of Solomon, the books of Solomon, wizards and sorcerers of dark arts, And they are dealing with someone who had no knowledge of any of this. I don't study any of these things. That's why I'm telling you it's never wise to put them, to put God, the Great Spirit, to the test. And this symbol is being used in a very horrible way with a quantum computer as some type of infinite ability, sexual, to do much harm to me sexually. And they're thinking they're going to be saved by zero, which is the symbol of the vagina. There was another scripture back in this area that I wanted to go to at first, 2 Thessalonians again, because I keep being drawn to that scripture concerning the falling away. The mystery of the lawlessness is already at work with that quantum computer. Let me go on and read this. Let no one deceive you by any means, for the day will not come unless the falling away comes first, and the man of sin is revealed, the son of perdition, who opposes and exalts himself above all that is called God, or that is worshipped, so that he sits as God in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. Do you remember that when I was still with you, I told you these things, and now you know what is restraining, that he might be revealed in his due time. For the mystery of lawlessness is already at work. Only he who now restrains will do so until he is taken out of the way. And when the lawless one will be revealed, whom the Lord will consume with the breath of his mouth and destroy with the brightness of his coming. The coming of the lawless one is according to the workings of Satan, with all power, signs, and lying wonders, and with all unrighteous deception among those who perish, because they did not receive the love of the truth, that they might be saved. And for this reason, God will send them strong delusions, that they should believe the lie. But they all may be condemned who did not believe the truth, and but had pleasure in unrighteousness. Taking pleasure and sex magic against me with this zero. Using dark ritual magic to curse me. So I ask you people early this morning, who do you think these four angels are going to obey and listen to? When some of you people are practicing these dark arts upon me in ritual and spells, who do you think the four angels who are holding back the four winds, who are unleashing the four winds, Raphael, Gabriel, Uriel, and Michael, who do you think they're going to listen to? What did I tell y'all? Watch every last one of these lesser gods do my bidding, because that's what angels are. And I don't have bragging rights, and I'm not trying to be arrogant. I'm just trying to let y'all know what y'all have not been told, and what y'all have not seen, y'all are being told, and y'all going to see. That this book is a grimoire, keys to the fallen realms, the ether in the heavens, and they've been operating from this for thousands of years. And it's an abomination now, and they are busted. This is lawlessness at its finest. And every one of y'all that have partaken in this have been deceived, not saved, and took pleasure in unrighteousness. By using a Z machine to section off my brain to access the outer worlds and to profane me with the zero, knowing that it has everything to do with sex magic. One and zero. Male, female. And they wanted y'all to believe that I was crazy, insane, evil, demon possessed. When this book is dealing with angels who are demons and demons who are angels playing two different roles, and y'all don't get it. Very sad. Yes, I have the wisdom and the intelligence. And it's coming from a very disabled brain that's been messed over really badly for the past 20 to 30 years now. They've blocked my brain, did these things to my brain, and I am disabled. And here I am showing you people the truth. Because I am of the truth. And I believe the Great Tribulation will happen because these gods that are playing with these, in this Bible, with these seals, the Kabbalah seals and the seals of Solomon, the books of Moses, they won't be able to perfect their dark magic. A part of them will cease to function. So when all of the, when their energies are dissolving and gone, there may be a lot of destructive energies taking place while they are dissolving. So y'all keep that in mind, people. Been in some deep thought about some of this. How they've used symbols to conjure with their invocations. And very soon, none of you dark magicians and sorcerers and wizards will have any control over the angelic energies. And nor will you have any control over me by using invocations, when y'all know that I am all the universes and have tried to fragment me in a very, very terrible way. All your formulas won't work. All your ceremonial ritual magic won't work. Because this is about truth and righteousness. And y'all took pleasure in unrighteousness and was being deceived. In this fallen realm. And did much harm to me. And y'all sit back, those that were involved, and don't want to acknowledge the type of game y'all played, using hermetic, Kabbalistic magic with the stars and the planets. That's That's why I told y'all your angels will bow. Because y'all did really play with the wrong one. Y'all did this to the wrong one. Y'all have a blessed morning today, people. That's all I'm going to tell you. They are all very busted.